This is App-Tronics' final approved SmartNav 5, which is set to start production in a week or so. In this video, we're going to show you some of the icons, applications, and functions, and how the mirror works, and everything it can offer you. I right now have it on a wide zoom, so I can show you some of the outside of the mirror and what it looks like inside the vehicle. This is your SD card for the DVR recorder. This is your camera right here, where you can adjust the angle for better viewing, which you can access through your DVR recorder. When you pull it up, you can see everything. It records everything you hear as well. This SD card does come with the SmartNav. I think it's an 8 gig, so it does record maybe a week of footage, depending on drive time. You can access that footage simply by taking the card out and putting it in your PC. It will automatically load an ADR player, so you can view all that footage and share it in minute increments or the whole trip. Over here is a secondary, or your main actual SD slot, where you use to upload your movies, music, and updates that will be coming out for SmartNav. Some updates would be red light cameras and speed traps, or interface changing, new icons or set paths. I'm going to go ahead and zoom in on the mirror, get you a better look at it, and we'll go through some of the functions of each icon. Now, this is your home screen. There are some people that would like to have less icons, so what we did for that is we gave you a theme setting. I'll show you the original look to the mirror with the home screen. Okay. This version here is every icon. It gives you two screens, and you would just scroll back and forth. If you go into themes, you can actually lower that to 3 and 6. 3 would be left, and what that's going to do is going to put the best 3 or most popular used icons on the left-hand side. Then you would simply go up to the blank screen, and then there's your 3 screens. You can change the wallpaper as well by double tapping there or tapping once it's in setting, and go up, and there's your 3 icons. Now, SmartNav will remain this way until you change it, because it has constant power, it retains memory. If you want to go to 6 icons, you would go to back to themes, go to below, and it's going to put the most popular 6 icons on the bottom. Then you would scroll over to your blank screen. Now, if there's an icon here that you want that's not there, or you want to switch them, let's say your ebook reader, you would hold that icon down and then move it and switch it with the other icon. Then go back to your secondary screen, which is blank, showing you those 6 icons. Up here in the right-hand corner, that lets you know if your FM transmitter is active, if your satellite's active, and if your Bluetooth's active. I'm going to go back to left. Hit save. And then we're going to start with navigation. This is the drive application. This is what you use when you're driving. Most important part of this display is the position. Make sure that's valid. That means your satellite signal is good and you can actually use your navigation path without harming the device. Not that you would harm it, but it would work slower because it's trying to retain that satellite signal. When you start your SmartNav, it links to your cell phone and the satellite within seconds. It retains that memory of where you were, so it always knows where the satellites are because of that constant power. You can see over here is your RF connection, which is for your radar detector. Some SmartNavs have a radar inside, but most have the wireless capability to upgrade and buy App-Tronics Stealth Interceptor 2300IS radar and laser diffusers, which are on the front end of the, end of the vehicle. You can buy those separate and have a combination package, and you will be alerted when you're hit by radar or law enforcement's engaging it with laser, and the diffusers will diffuse that laser so they can't read your speed. Your alert mute speed is the speed at which you'll be alerted when radar is advancing or hitting you. So, and if you're going below 30, you will not be alerted to radar and laser diffusing. If you, the red light and speed trap database is very in-depth. There's many locations in the States, in Canada, but if there's a location that's not on our database, you can add it here. And then you would change that speed. If you know the speed of the intersection or street that it's at, you would hit save, and it's going to retain that information for you and add to your database. Your setting page over here, this is where you can turn your radar on and off and also set your alert mute speed, which we talked about a few minutes ago, which would, again, now it's at 50, you wouldn't be alerted until you're above 50 miles per hour to radar and laser. We're going to go ahead and go into IGO Primo. All your navigation is under Navi A and Navi B. SmartNav only comes with IGO Primo, fully featured. It's actually on the mirror, so you never have to worry about using A or B. Just touch A or B, and it'll take you right to IGO Primo. There's a lot of features with IGO. We're just going to go through a few of them really quick. If you go to app-tronics.com, you can view more of what it can all do. And we'll try typing in a destination, show you how quick that can be. Or actually, we'll try finding a place to eat. You'd go to a restaurant. It's going to bring up every restaurant near you. Keep going until you find something you like. You would touch that. And what we're going to do, we're going to simulate the drive instead of going. So you would hit more and simulate navigation. And what IGO is going to do, it's going to
take the next right.
Take us through the actual trip.
Take the next right.
You can hear the turn-by-turn directions. You can also add a speed alert. It will show you the speed limit of every street and alert you when
take
you're speeding.
The next right.
So every time you're above the set speed limit of the street you're on, it will tell you that you're speeding and show you that speed. And it will also alert you to radar and laser. If you buy the SmartNav with radar and laser diffusing and you are hit, it will alert you, it will show you like this.
After quarter of a mile, turn right.
You can see the laser right there. X-band right there. That's how they would show up if you had the stealth package or the interior radar. Okay, we're going to go ahead and exit out of this. Some other nice features that I like, especially as a music player. If you want to access your music that you have uploaded to the mirror, you can do that. And then go back to your navigation. You can create a playlist and control it right from the mirror. You can set your POI database here. There's an actual secondary POI database. Which is quite large. It's very advanced and again can be updated through applicational.com. So you'll get even more of a larger database for POIs and speed traps when you're using IGO. Here's your speed warnings. So you can set your speed limit or set it to when you want it to alert you if you're speeding. Go back to your music player. That stop it. Again, those are just some of the basic functions of this mirror. If you want to put an address in, it's very quick. It doesn't take long at all, especially if you've been there before. You would hit the check mark and then start typing in your street name, and it comes up very fast. Again, you would hit the check mark And put your house number. Done. And go. That's about it. To cancel our route, route options, cancel. Cancel route. And that's pretty much I go on a quick scan. It also has 3D imaging of buildings, so when you go into downtown or large areas, it will show you those maps or those buildings in 3D. Now we're going to show you the radar. It actually warns you a little bit better. Actually, I had the alert mute speed on, so when I was showing you before, it wouldn't give you the verbal warning. So we're going to set the alert mute speed at 0. And then whenever you're in drive or on IGO,
radar expand.
It's going to give you X, K, KU, KA, and laser.
Radar laser. Radar KA band.
And then K. There you go. If those are alerting, you can double tap them and they'll close out. That's a quick way to get rid of them. Now we'll go to the music player. Now this is basically the same music player that was on IGO. If you have a playlist, it will automatically start playing. You can load those. Let's see, I'm going to get rid of these three here, show you how to load. If you have them on your SD card, you double tap, it'll bring them up. You hit all green to bring them all over. That's your playlist. And hit play. You have an equalizer set to certain users. You can minimize it here so you can still do other things on the mirror. If you want to shut it down, you actually have to shut it down by hitting the power button. Your Bluetooth is here. It connects to your phone in a matter of seconds. I think it's 1 to 3. Load your phone book. Usually immediately. I didn't load here because I had just paired this phone, but usually when you start the car, it loads immediately. You can scroll down to individual and then call that person by touching their name. One of the nice features on SmartNav is the smartphone integration with A2DP firmware, meaning you can play your music that's on your phone right through the mirror. Day and night. So if you want to change your music, you can do that. And you can also control it from your phone as well. You can power that down and it will continue to play your music. If a phone call were to come in, the main screen's going to come up, telling you I have a phone call. It's going to take, SmartNav will take over the most important sounds you need to hear. So if a phone call comes in or your turn-by-turn directions, it's going to shut those down so you can take the call. Now if I were to take this call, and we're on a phone call right now, you can still access everything. And then end that call. And then your music's going to come back on. This is actually connected to the FM transmitter. I'm going to turn it down. But you can tell if a screen does come up, you can always minimize them. And if you're running that program, it will still run. And you can bring it back up and turn it off later. So if a phone call is coming in and you answer it and you can't see or hear your turn-by-turn directions for IGO, you would just simply power down that button, that screen, and your phone call would still remain on. Go back into your Bluetooth, music, pause the music. We'll go to the movie player. Now, This will not work while you're driving, but it's still kind of nice to have. You have to go in, find your movies and your SD card by double tapping, and then go ahead and play that movie by double tapping again. SmartNav plays nearly every format you can think of, and it will play high action without any issues.
Looks damn good, Mr. President, but I'm gonna need that suit back.
By double tapping the screen, you can go back to the movie player and pause or stop it.
President is secure, Tony. I'm clearing the area.
Nice work.
And exit out. Flash player and the RMV player are the same thing. They just play different formats. Your photo viewer for your uploaded photos. You would tap here. Go into your SD card. And view your photos. You can also play them as a movie. Just by pressing play, and it will go through each movie, or each picture as a movie slide. You can zoom in on that picture, zoom out, or double tap it, and it'll just show the image. Go back and exit out. FM transmitter. This is where you set your FM transmitter, so go through your car speakers. SmartNav also comes with a auxiliary port tied directly into your car, so you can get two ways to tie into your vehicle's audio system, either by FM transmitter or through the auxiliary port. Your theme settings are here. This is again where you can change your theme to 3 to 6 icons or all the icons, and then you would, if you like a certain wallpaper, you would choose that wallpaper and then display that. And again, SmartNav will retain that memory. Every time you start your vehicle, you only have those 6 icons shown. The reverse camera is in 5-inch HD, so every time you put the car into reverse, it's going to show you the rear image. Please do not depend on that solely. Make sure you check your surrounding areas when using a reverse camera. You can tell how fast it comes back on. You have your language settings, your system settings, your brightness is has a delay, which we really like. At nighttime, you can put it at, let's say, 10 seconds and hit save. And then after 10 seconds, that screen's going to diminish to where it's not so bright, so you don't have to worry about it all the time or change it every day from night and day. You can see it diminish, and you just one-touch it, and it brightens back up. During the nighttime, that's pretty essential to use, even though you can still see through the image. You can focus in and out of it and see what's behind you very easily. It may look like you can't, but you can. You can see right through it. You just have to focus in and out of it. But the brightness delay will help you see through that image. During the daytime, it's set up to where you should probably use one of the lighter wallpapers, like white or this one, so you can see better during the day. That's about every function that we'd like to show you today. And you got your volume settings, which are pretty simple. There's so much more to show. Just wanted to be a quick video, but there's just so much involved with SmartNav that we want to show you and get you excited about. The warranty is unbelievable. It's 3 years. If you are to buy SmartNav from one of our authorized dealers at a dealership with a new vehicle purchase, we match that car's warranty. So if your car has 4 or 5 years, SmartNav would retain that warranty. But it does have to be installed by an authorized dealer. If you have any other questions, you can call us at 1-888-587-4111. 1-888-587-4111, or go to apptronics.com, APP-TRONICS.com. and see more videos and more product information on SmartNav, and show you actually the combination between that we put together with the stealth interceptor radar and laser diffusers, which right now we're extremely proud of. It's the only laser diffusers that can truly beat Laser Alley 100% of the time. We have the best laser diffusers in the world, and radar detection up to a mile. We have really put together a great system here. App-Tronics is all about putting quality products with unbelievable warranty and customer service. You'll find that when you purchase a SmartNav, you will not be disappointed. The DVR recorder, again, is a great tool to have. Here's what that screen looks like. You can access the actual, you can actually just muted it there. You can mute the interior cab, or you can actually view your photos or your videos on the SmartNav instead of waiting on your home PC. I forgot I got the dimmer on. See if I can show you a video driving here. Well, it's playing, but there we go. Yeah, I think it's pretty much recorded our whole conversation. So, no actual drive times left on here. Again, go to applicational.com, applicational.com.